Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. We'll start with the news from Microsoft that it will lay off 18,000 employees in the next year. CEO Satya Nadella said its work towards synergies and strategic alignment on Nokia devices and services is expected to account for about 12,500 jobs being cut. The company's device lineup will change as well. The low-end Android-based Nokia X phones will survive, but not as Android phones. Instead, Nadella said Microsoft will shift select Nokia X product designs to become Lumia products running Windows Phone. Microsoft has about 127,000 employees, and half of which are based in the U.S. Apple and IBM announced a deal in which IBM will build a new line of enterprise-specific apps from the ground up for Apple's iOS. The apps will be aimed at companies in retail, healthcare, transportation, and other industries. IBM will create unique cloud services for iOS, including tools for security, analytics, and device management. It will also resell iPhones and iPads to its corporate customers, and Apple will roll out new support services for businesses. Yahoo came out with disappointing second quarter earnings, but announced it's keeping a larger stake in Alibaba after its IPO and returning at least half of the proceeds to shareholders. Sales for the quarter were $1.04 billion, missing expectations from Wall Street analysts. Sales are down 4% from the same quarter a year ago. Earnings per share missed expectations by a penny, coming in at 37 cents a share.
While it's clear we have work to do on our display business, I want to be clear that the progress we saw this quarter, especially around the new ad technology that we rolled out towards the end of the quarter, will have a long-term measurable impact on our ability to transform Yahoo.
The earnings results come around the two-year anniversary of Marissa Mayer's appointment as CEO. Since 2012, her efforts to turn Yahoo around include redesigning legacy products like the homepage and email, acquiring startups for engineering talent, a mobile push with its apps, and a focus on video. NASA's free-flying space robots called Spheres will soon be upgraded with Google's Project Tango 3D smartphones. An Orbital Sciences rocket launched on Sunday with a capsule carrying the smartphones and other supplies for the International Space Station. You might be familiar with Google's effort to create 3D-enabled smartphones and tablets called Project Tango. The devices use a custom 3D sensor and cameras to track their own position and create a 3D model of the surrounding area. Starting early next month, the astronauts will turn the sensors on and take spheres throughout the station to map its entire layout. NASA will then upload it to the robots so that they can use the maps to navigate throughout the space station on their own. Last week, when I was on Cape Cod, I had the chance to try out new waterproof Bluetooth speakers from Outdoor Tech, and I was impressed. The smaller turtle shell costs about $130, while the larger big turtle shell about $230. The real draw for these speakers is their durability. They're rated to IPX5 standards, so short of being submerged, they'll continue playing your tunes. Both have multifunction buttons on the front. You can pause music, increase and decrease the volume, and change tracks for the device. Both speakers offer 16 hours of playtime. You can see more in my full review at the link below. Well, that's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. To find out what's coming up on every week's show, be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. I'm Nick Barber, and for all of us here at the IDG News Service, thanks for watching, and we hope to see you next week.